Hello students, looking at current affairs for 27th May, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these 9. We'll look at them in detail. The first one, PM reviews LAC standoff with National Security Advisor, Chief of Defence Staff and the 3 service chiefs. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi reviewed the current situation on the line of actual control, which is the boundary between India and China. So the ongoing standoff with China was reviewed by Prime Minister with National Security Advisor Ajit Doval, Chief of Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat and the 3 service chiefs. So several rounds of talks on the ground up of the up to the level of division commanders have taken place, but they have failed to break the impasse. Even early in the day, Defence Minister Rajnath Singh held a review of ongoing military reforms. So the military reforms have been undertaken implementing the recommendations of Shekatkar committee. So you should know about this committee, Shekatkar committee, which has recommended military reforms. But then even at this meeting, the Ladakh standoff was the one which was discussed in detail. So Minister of External Affairs on its part has issued only one statement on the tensions at LAC, that too after Chinese Ministry of Foreign Affairs had accused Indian troops of crossing the line across Ladakh and Sikkim of infringement activities and of attempting to unilaterally change the status of border control. So Chinese Ministry of Foreign Affairs had accused India. So on this, Ministry of External Affairs of India had issued one statement and said that Chinese troops were hindering India's normal patrolling patterns and denied Chinese accusations. So a face-off has been seen between the troops on Indian and Chinese side at least 3 points in Ladakh and even at the Nakula Pass in Sikkim. So number of Chinese troops at the line of actual control in areas where India patrols have increased, even including at the Galwan River Valley and as such. And Chinese troops are blocking Indian patrols in some areas in Pangong So Lake also in Ladakh. So defense sources have denied reports of a major buildup of Chinese troops across the LAC in Uttarakhand as well. So this is the middle sector of LAC. So northeastern region comes towards the east. Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir region comes towards the west. And the middle section is Uttarakhand section. So there are reports of even Chinese troops building up in Uttarakhand, the middle sector of LAC too, particularly in Joshimath Harsil area. But Indian troops, but defense sources have denied such reports. A Chinese newspaper actually has blamed India for the standoff. It says India in recent days has illegally constructed defense facilities across the border into Chinese territory in the Galwan Valley region. And this, it says, is resulting in Chinese troops preparing for a response. We have undertaken road construction work, but that is within Indian region. It was not encroaching into Chinese territory. But these boundaries are not settled yet. Means we have a boundary dispute with China. LAC is the boundary which has been determined by a British commission. So that is not. McMahon line is the one which we agreed to. But the Chinese side said that this was British colonial rulers who unilaterally set up this line. It was not with Chinese consent. So they do not accept this boundary. And that's why boundary commissions have been set up and they have boundary dispute resolution committees have been set up and discussions are still going on to resolve India-China boundary dispute. And in that context, we see this problem arising right now, the standoff. So here you can see the western side is Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir region. So it's a border of about 2150 kilometers. It separates Jammu and Kashmir from Xinjiang province of China, which is again a region of unrest in China. That's why the Aksai Chin region of India has also been taken over by China. So it is illegally occupied by China after the 1962 India-China war. And this is the boundary along Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. This is said to be the least controversial boundary, the middle sector. Then we have here bounded China in Sikkim also and in Arunachal Pradesh. China actually considers entire Arunachal Pradesh to be belonging to itself. So that is also there. Even when citizens from Arunachal Pradesh, Indians from Arunachal Pradesh visit China, it does not provide them visas as such. The visas, it provides them visas. It does not provide visa stamps on their passports. Rather, it staples visas on their passport because it does not accept them as Indian nationals, as their Indian passport. Accepting Indian passport means accepting their Indian nationals. So they don't accept their. So this is the way they behave too. So they call Arunachal Pradesh to be belonging to China. So such are the demands of China. And the dispute continues. Then next is Xi meets PLA, urges battle preparedness. So Chinese President Xi Jinping has called on the military to think about worst case scenarios and scale up battle preparedness. So this was the annual meeting between the Chinese President, the meeting which he had with the People's Liberation Army representatives, which is the armed forces of the Chinese. So they were attending the National People's Congress, that is the Parliament of China in Beijing. And here the Chinese President made this remark. He also referred to the battle preparedness earlier also, like in 2019 also, similar views were given. And also you should know that presently with respect to Taiwan also, China is seeing heightened tensions. The National People's Congress, the Parliament's annual report of 2020, first time mentioned reunification with Taiwan without the prefix peaceful. So every year it calls for peaceful reunification with Taiwan, but this time it has, the word peaceful has been dropped. So that has raised concerns too. Then next is, no World Health Organization bar on India testing hydroxychloroquine as preventive. So World Health Organization moratorium on testing hydroxychloroquine, the controversial anti-malarial drug which has been used for treating COVID-19. So this moratorium on its testing has been announced by World Health Organization on 25th May 2020. But India is using this drug as a preventive. So testing the drug as a preventive should not stop. That's what the chief scientist of World Health Organization, Dr. Soumya Swaminathan, says. So hydroxychloroquine is actually one of the four drug combinations being tested in a global clinical trial coordinated by World Health Organization, which is called Solidarity Trial. And in this moratorium on testing, hydroxychloroquine has been announced by World Health Organization. So under the Solidarity Trial, actually 400 hospitals in 35 countries are comparing the benefits of these drugs on COVID-19 patients. So there is a randomized clinical trial taking place. What is a randomized clinical trial? You should understand it's a medically legitimate approach to test drugs. So some groups of patients unknown to the administrating doctors and recipients would get the drug and some wouldn't. So a spate of studies actually have been undertaken. So in this randomized trial means one of the four drugs would be given. Who is given what is not known. So clearly the results will be based on the response, not on any preconceived notions. But there are other studies which show that hydroxychloroquine shows no benefit. In fact, it puts patients at greater harm. So such studies have also been published, but then in the medical journal Lancet. And it found that in 96,000 hospitalized SARS-CoV patients across 6 continents, there was no benefit, even additional harm of cardiac arrhythmia. We have seen about this earlier too. Means it caused this problem in the heart. So they were being treated with hydroxychloroquine and they were having these harms. But then there are concerns being raised because these are not randomized clinical trials. Rather, these are observational studies. So observational study will not have the same results because there will be objectivity will not be there clearly in that. So that is why they cannot be taken seriously. But we have seen World Health Organization putting moratorium on testing hydroxychloroquine. But then these are tests being conducted. Why would that be stopped? Because hydroxychloroquine is actually basically an anti-malarial drug. And Indian government, the health ministry, has also recommended the drug as a preventive. So we have seen how this has been suggested as a preventive treatment for even healthcare workers. And now even frontline workers, we have seen this in news few days back, that even for frontline workers like armed forces, the police personnel as such should also be taking this drug to ensure that they do not get infected by COVID-19. So, Health Ministry's stance is based on internal studies and laboratory experiments that show that the drug has antiviral properties. So, Dr. Swaminathan of World Health Organization says that World Health Organization is not advising stopping all hydroxychloroquine trials. The suspension of enrollment applies only to the Solidarity Trial. So, in the Solidarity Trial, which has been undertaken for 4 drugs, now it seems that hydroxychloroquine will not be tested. So there's a moratorium and test on that. Actually, other drugs, you can see in the Solidarity Trial, there are 4 drugs which are being tested. That is Remdesivir, which is actually a drug which is used for antivirus, as an antivirus. Then Lopinavir, Ritonavir, which is actually HIV drug. And there is a combination of Lopinavir, Ritonavir also. And plus also hydroxychloroquine. So hydroxychloroquine is an anti-malarial drug and it's the cheapest. It's very cheap. Lopinavir, Ritonavir are HIV drugs which are costly. Remdesivir is also costly. And now World Health Organization has called for moratorium on testing hydroxychloroquine, which is of concern now, because it has shown results even in India. The next is Glenmark to conduct faith trials. So Glenmark Pharmaceuticals Limited is now going to have a new randomized open label study to test the combined efficacy of two antiviral drugs, favipiravir and umifenovir. So in favipiravir, we have already seen government had given it permission. It is undertaking phase 3 clinical trials, but now it is looking at combined efficacy of two drugs, and it has called this new combination clinical trial as FAITH. That is favipiravir plus umifenovir efficacy and safety trial in Indian hospital settings. So it will see the two antiviral drugs which have different mechanism of action. So how the combination will improve treatment efficacy is being looked with clinical trial. So it has shown potential and it is being tested now. So we should know that actually in SARS-CoV, the viral load peaks at the around the same time as the symptom onset. Means it takes 14 days for patient to show symptoms. Till that time the patient may be asymptomatic, and in that time the viral load peaks. So early administration of this combination by acting by different mechanisms is desirable for treatment of COVID-19 is what Glenmark says. The next is ensure transport food for migrants. Supreme Court tells center states. So a 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court said that there have been inadequacies and certain lapses on the part of central and state government in dealing with migrant workers crisis during the COVID-19 lockdown. So central and state should immediately provide transport, food and shelter free of cost to stranded migrant workers. And the 3-judge bench of the Supreme Court took this case suo motu cognizance of media reports and some representation from senior lawyers too. The next is recovery rate up, says Health Ministry. So India's COVID recovery rate has improved from 26.59% on 2nd May to 41.61% on 26th May. The Ministry of Health says that this improved recovery should not allow complacency to set in, because still we have a long drawn battle against COVID-19 to continue. The case fatality rate has also shown a downward trend from 3.3% to 2.87%. Means out of all COVID-19 patients, 2.87% died, which is lowest amongst the world. Global average is of 6.45%. So recovery rate has improved and fatality rate has gone down. So this is the graph shown here of recovery rate increasing. Next is Arogya Setu app is now open source, says government. So amid concerns over privacy of data being collected through the COVID-19 contact tracing app, that is Arogya Setu app, government has now announced that it will be open sourcing the code. The code will be available open source. It has also launched a bug bounty program wherein financial rewards will be given to security researchers for finding any vulnerability in the application or suggesting improvements on the source code. So this bug bounty program will be open to all Indian and foreign nationals, but only Indians will be eligible for the rewards under the scheme. So for pointing out a security vulnerability, a reward of up to 3 lakh will be given, and for pointing out any suggestion or improvement in the source code, reward of up to 1 lakh would be given. Then next is fisheries scheme has no relief component. So this is regarding Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. So this was announced by the central government as part of the economic stimulus package, the Ayushman Bharat Yojana, which was of 20 lakh crores. So this is a scheme involving more than 20,000 crore investment from center, state and beneficiaries over a 5-year period. So it aims to increase fish production by 9%, double income of farmers and even double export earnings in 5 years by 2024-25. But then it does not involve any component aimed at relief or financial assistance to provide immediate help to the hard-hit fisheries sector. So the fisheries minister Giriraj Singh, he dismissed the demand for immediate financial assistance, especially in light of economic losses due to the lockdown. So it's not just the coronavirus, even the cyclone Imphan has hit fish workers significantly along the east coast. The annual monsoon fishing ban is also there, which will come into effect in a few days, though the Ministry of Fisheries has reduced the duration of annual fishing ban in the monsoon season. It is of 61 days, it has been reduced to 47 days on the demand of mechanized fishing boat owners. So this is to provide some COVID-19 relief. The ban as such during monsoon season is there to ensure that fish spawning takes place, means fish can reproduce, which takes place during the monsoon. So regeneration of fish stock can take place. So this is there. And the last news is GDP contract to contract by 5% in financial year 2025. So this is the credit rating agency CRISIL, which says that it expects India's economy to shrink by 5%. Means it will be -5% during the current financial year because nationwide lockdown has crippled economic activity. The non-farm growth rate is actually going to contract by 6%. It will be -6%. But agriculture activity is continuing, which will provide a cushion, which will grow at 2.5%. So it will be overall contraction of 5%. The first quarter of April to June 2020 is expected to suffer a staggering 25% contraction, means -25% growth. And it says about 10% of GDP in real terms could be permanently lost. So it has says country has India has seen recession only thrice in the past 69 years, in 1958, 1966 and 1980. And the reason each time was monsoon shock that had hit the agriculture sector, and which is, was a sizable part of the economy. But now this year's recession is because of non-farm sectors, because of the pandemic-induced lockdown, which has affected most non-agriculture sectors. Also, global disruption has taken away any Indian opportunity for export also. So this is the situation of the economy, which is predicted. So that is it. Thank you.